Hello everyone, welcome back to another Sudoku video. Now normally I don't attempt these kind of challenges, but this is a little killer. So I figure why not? Six could be 1, 2, 3, could be one repeating and then a 4. 19, that was a big number. 6 times 3 is 18. Could have 3 sixes and a 1. What about 17? These have to be pretty small, right? The least I could get in these squares would be 3 and 4, which would add to 7, leaving 10 in these 4 squares. Whoops. That's doable. Clue. 6, 6, and 6 add to 16. So it could be a 4 here and 1's there. I don't think these could be 4's. Because if this were a 4, the 1 would repeat. And if this were the 4, oh actually that would work. If this were 1, then that would force all of those into being 6's. Is a possibility. Actually, no. Because this can't be a 6. If this were a 2. Actually, this 6 is in 2 spots. It's either 5, 1. Two and four. This 19 clue only goes across 4 cells, but this is way bigger. So let's see, if these were the lowest that they could be, then these would have to sum to 10. So many ways of doing that. I do feel like this 3 clue is helpful though. So if this is 3 and 4, this would be 5 and 6. The idea of this being a 1 is that that would be a 4 and that would be a 1. This actually can't be a 1. This could be 2, 3, 1. Could be 3, 1, 2. But this can't be 4, 1. This can't be a 2 now, because if this were a 2, then you would need a 2 and a 2. Actually, the minimum this could be is 4. This can't be either of those. That's a 1. One of these is 2, the other one is 3. Oh, but the 1 figures out this area. This can no longer be 1, 5. It's either 1, 5 like that, or 2, 4 in any way. Say this is a 3. Those 3 squares would have to add to 12. It's a 2, then they add to 13. So what's the total of a little killer row? 1 plus 2 is 3. 3 plus 3 is 6. 6 plus 4 is 10. 10 plus 5 is 15. So 16 is the total for each row and column. This 7 clues where I have to look. What's the least I could put? I could do 5 here, 1's here. Plus 2, the 1 there. Can I have a 6 in either of these two spots? So we get 7. From this square at the minimum, which brings us down to 17. So if we have a 6 here, then we would need 1, 1, and 2. Seems perfectly possible. I thought I could get the 6 here down to those 2 spots. If this is a 1 and this is a 2. Then that's 3. Those 2 squares to be way too high. So I don't think that this could be a 1. Because even if this is a 1 and that's a 3, that's 4, which leaves 15 for these 2 squares. Be a 3. Actually, if this is a 2, this is a 3, that's 5. 19 minus 5 is 14, which is too little. This were a 3 and this were a 3, that would be 19 minus 6, which leaves 13, which also doesn't work. This has to be a 4. Four plus 3 is 7, which leaves a 6 here and here. So 12 plus 4 leaves behind 3. My brain is working very slow. I need a 2 and a 1 in the 7 clue. Now we've got 3 here, so these both need to be 6. I'm glad it flashes so brightly. Alright, so every diagonal is completed except for the 17. So we have 15 to squeeze into 5 squares. Sixes. Actually, let me do some pencil marks real quick. So all the twos are done. Do all the ones as well. Things fully notated. 17 minus 3 is 14. So the minimum value here is 7. We got a margin of error of 1, which means if this is 5 and that's 4, we get 9 plus 3 is 12 plus 3 is 15, which goes over, so this can't be 5. For some reason it's a lot harder for me to read the smaller things. That could just be me though. Now we got 4 plus 2 plus 4 plus 3 plus 1. 4 plus 3 is 7, 8, 10, 14. That's a 3. Not bad, you could probably do it better, but that's my first time trying out one of these little killers. Normally I think the math is too hard, but this one is small. So I said, what the heck. I'll see you on the next one, thanks for watching.